Ready, guys?
Yeah.
Okay, we start. Hello? Today we're going to do all sorts of articulations with the hips. The meaning of it is not to become more flexible or to dance. The meaning of it is to understand the movement that goes through the hips and the movement that we can facilitate with the hips. For example, someone comes and pushes or strikes me, I can allow things to move, articulate, and simply control, not by being forceful or being faster, but by simply being more aware. If we do it slower, for example, from the back, if something pushes me here, if I become tense, I'm simply forgetting that I have hips. If I don't forget and I remember that I can walk, then it can become quite different. And it looks as if the other person is playing along. From the side, if someone pushes me, if I again forget that I have the hips, I become like this, I become tense. And if I'm really tense and someone pushes me, which looks quite funny. Unless, of course, it's a real attack. Now, if someone, again, attacks you, and you're with your breath, you are able to do this very simply. Not by force again, do it slower. No need for damage here. See here, this moves. You can just continue to move. And that's the whole point. You continue to move, you continue to stay alive. So, let's begin with a very simple movement. The actual point of the hips, you know, the center of the hips does move in this location. It moves in a circle around the legs. So from here you move this way, or I'll show it from the side again. This is a very simple one, and pretty much everyone does this from time to time. So let's do 10 and 10. Allow your breath to lead the movement. And very important, pay attention to how the movement of the hips changes the spine, the tension in the muscles around the spine, and the way that the mass is dispersed between the legs and within the foot itself, how the mass shifts around. Okay, that's enough of that. Now, we go every time just one step further. We move the most basic thing. Now we'll do a bit of a spine articulation above the hips, meaning that the hips are now going to be the center. And they also move, but they move somewhat more within, meaning that they create the contrast of tension to hold our body up, and from there on. I'll start with the shoulder. I show from the side and from the front. From here, I do a circle of the shoulders around the hips. So from here, see, one way, the other way. I'll show from the front again. The shoulders, the area of the spine around the shoulders just relaxes, side, back, do 10 and 10, 10 each direction. Just 10. Make sure that you're not displacing the movement of the shoulders to a movement of the hips, because it feels very natural to do this, but it's a very different movement. And if let's say someone tries to move you, let's say grabs your shoulder, and you're trying to move, you see, with the hips, instead of starting the movement where you want it, they're just going to be grabbed. For example, if someone comes and grabs you, see, if I tense, I'm not aware of what I'm doing. If he does that again, and I'm just moving the shoulders around the spine, then it's a lot easier for me. If I, for example, take Michael and sort of like take him to a point where it's harder for him to move, here, if it starts to move into the hips now, see, it just aggravates it. But if he relaxes the shoulder around the hip, then it's a very different animal. So 10 and 10, complete this. Allow your breathing again to lead the movement. And notice how when you breathe in, it also compresses your inside. Now let's go a step further. Instead of the shoulders, we jump to the bottom of the chest here. And from here, I'll show this from two directions. From here, this is the point that does not move, but we move this around the hip. So it's from this, goes a bit further. The hips supply us with dynamic stabilization, and it holds us in a dynamic way that the weight shifts around. So again, from the front, let's all thank the car that is parked behind us and making noise. Just 10 and 10. Make sure that you're not letting go of tension in a place where you don't want to. Too much relaxation is not very lively. It just flops around. And that's not necessarily something you want, especially underground. Now let's go one step further to the area of the bottom of the ribs. If you don't feel it, just put your fingers here and know that you're in a good position. Some people have to feel it or see it. So from here I go all the way down till this here, and as you can see, the hips, especially from the side, is visible. At the feet, the legs and the hips have to compensate for the change in mass dispersion, you know, here. And this goes dynamically around. So you go all the way, the spine moves around the hips. 10 and 10. Another thing that you see from this, especially from this height and onward, is that the arms and shoulders move from the body. And this allows you for a much greater production of effective force. If someone grabs me, for example, if I try to bring the arm to me, tension. If I just relax it, see, it's a lot different, and it does not show to the other person. If someone grabs me from behind or something like that, they'll hear, well, this is not very effective, you know, with intention, you know, here. If people resist, that's the only way that this hold is working, because he's just touching me in two places, I can just take a step. But other than that, you know, here, how does this work? If I want to move away and I try to move the hand, I tense against the object that I'm touching, just naturally. Instead, see, relax it, see, relax it, and then it looks like the other person is playing along. Doesn't matter if he does it. Okay, so again, you do 10 and 10 here. Now we go to the stomach area, and when I talk about the front parts, I actually more refer to the corresponding parts in the spine. Yes, so you learn to move from your spine to your breath. Take note of the compression of the breathing, especially on the inhale. Take note of the arms moving from the movement of the body, and take note of whatever it is around you. If you're just within yourself, it's somewhat ineffective again. So again, from here, I'll show from the side, from the stomach area or from the lower back area, you relax, relax to the side, to the back, and the hips compensate. One way and then the other. Allow your eyes to look around again. So it's not like so. You're allowing yourself to look. Very important. So let's say that we've done 10 and 10 of these. Now we go full on to the hips. Now we rotate fully. What does that mean? From here, I go all the way down, here, all the way, something like that, and the arms circulate as much as possible. Very good work for the health of the spine as well, and also it helps clears all sorts of things around the movement itself, in contact, before contact, and after. For example, if someone finds me at a disadvantage, if I'm bent over, like tying my shoe or something, someone comes to push me, if I tense against it, I get caught, or if he kicks me, you know, here. I'll be pushed in a way. Instead, if from here I'm allowing myself to keep moving, that's very different. if someone catches me and pulls me or whatever, just continue to move. The same way if you're just standing up in your bent,
pushes you.
Instead of trying to get up, if it's, for example, from the back, which is the best way to,
stab people from here, if I'm just thinking
forward, I'm being controlled. But if my spine is more relaxed and my eyes and everything moves freely, that's a good thing. Now that we've worked a bit, a small bit on the spine, around the hips, we're going to move on the hips themselves. From here, we'll start with a very simple movement. The hips are going to tilt on the spine that doesn't move now, forward and backwards. It's sort of like a plane that goes this way and that way, like a ship in a way. And this, the bottom of the spine, does not move. So it's not forward from the side, forward and backward. That's not the idea. This does not move, it moves on it, you see, from the side or from the front. See here, 10 and 10 of these, allow the movement to work with the legs, not opposite, like so. Now, an application of this is very simple. If I'm being pushed here, I just allow it to move further, do it slower. From here, see, contact is made. If I'm stiff here, not aware, a step. So I'm being pushed, move. And maybe there's nothing to hold me back there. Instead, from here, you just relax. You are able to continue to move and allow things to go through you. Obviously, not hot liquids or metals. If it comes, for example, from the back, continue to move. Now we'll do the same thing, only from side to side. When you're doing it front and back, it's easy because both legs are doing the same thing. You see? Both legs doing the same thing and both legs doing the same thing. When you do the same thing side to side, meaning that the boat rocks this way on the spine, it means that each leg has to either lengthen or shorten in a way. How do you control it? By simply relaxing one leg. Yes, and then the other one simply accepts the weight because this is one bone, hopefully. So from here, you can put your hands on your hips for this. See, relax, relax. You see, this part does not move. Breathe and move, breathe and move. Don't allow if you are a shooter, this does not move. If you are holding a baby, you don't wake it up. Maybe he likes to sway and so on. And this works the same way for pushes and pulls. We just allow the movement to continue with you. Yes, without excess tension. So we've done 10 of these. Now we'll do a full circle. Before that, let's try to explore your awareness of the hips and divide it, instead of just right side, left side, into four quadrants. So you have the front right, the front left, the back right, and the back left. If I would have made mistake now, it would have been really funny with the directions. So what we do now is go 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that it doesn't mean that this moves out of the way. It moves on the base of the spine. So if I'm holding a baby, a gun, whatever, it does not move. See here, the other direction. Allow yourself to breathe calmly and normally. And from the front, you see this does not move, you move around it. 10 in each direction. And that's good. Now, let's do a different movement. From here, we're going to take this again, the center does not move. We extend one side while the other one goes backwards. This lengthens the spine and releases some tension from time to time. So I'll show this from the front and from the side. Front, left front, right front. Left front, right front, or from the side. Left, right, like in the arm. Like so. Now about 10 or 20 of these. Like so. Now, Let's do this in a very simple way. Remember that we did the circle around, one way and the other way. Now we're going to do it in a linear fashion, from side to side. So the hips do move, and the legs have to correspond, and the feet have to change the mass ratio and the displacement in the different parts of the leg. And also the upper body is affected. See, it's this way and that way, side to side. But allow it to work naturally. Don't push and don't pull yourself. Just as much as it is needed, from side to side 10 times. So, just relax from leg to leg, but from the hips. Start it from the hips. If you start from the legs, the moment that you lose a purchase, you fall down. If you start from the hips, you lose a purchase, you just continue to move. There's a big difference there. Okay, now let's do it forward and backwards, meaning that it's not a tilting movement, but just the whole hips move forward and back. Yes? Forward and backwards. So, and again, this opens up and stretches the spine and the muscles a bit. Not after a double pizza, but mostly. And now we will combine to create an 8 pattern, the two movements that we've done last. So we've done this, and we've done this, and we've done this. I'll show the combination in a very simple way. I start to do this, and then I add to it a movement from side to side. I create a very simple 8 pattern by just doing two things at the same time. Again, here, you see, this, I just do this with the hips, and I relax the legs from side to side. Able to do two things at the same time with the movement of your hips, when you are being impacted in some way, hit something, hit me, here, you are just able to allow it to transfer through you without excess tension. If from here I just do this, or just do this, or just do this, I become caught, and this works with both with movement and also works with hitting. Okay, please. Here, if someone actually hits you and you are trying to hold it or trying to do one movement, it becomes a very short path groundward, or it just enters you, which is not so great as well. But if you're able to just relax and continue to do two things at the same time, not three, just two. Here, see, you just allow it to move, not just in a separate way which stretches you and put things inside. I will show once. Here, sorry, here, if I go in a linear way, see, you can just compensate with extension. If it's relaxed, see, then it goes more in. If his, back is stiff, sorry. I give him very little, but it really goes inside, as you can see from the leg shaking. Now, do this, you know, the 8 figure. Again. Anything? That's the point. Alright, now we'll change to the opposite 8 figure, which meaning that I go forward and backwards, but I also do this at the same time. I'm doing an 8 figure in the air, front and back, yes? This way, and also this way at the same time. This is something that you can almost do in any age, and it's both healthy and, well, also good for being able to take and transfer and impact. It doesn't have to be impact that comes necessarily from people. It could be different things as well. Alright, now that we've done that, we've done the front and side, let's again go back to the 4 quadrants. So what we're going to do is do a linear movement, sort of a linear movement, from the left to there and from the right to here. So you see this? We go from one side, you see, for example, I'm placing more weight on the little fingers, the little toes of the left foot here, and then I'm going to the right side of the heel on the other side. One side, see? I'm sort of like drawing an X on the cross that I have. Now let's do it in the other way. So we've done this angle, now we'll do this angle. So it's like a 45 degrees, forward and back, yes? Forward and back. Make sure that you notice the way that the weight transfers on the feet and how it displays in the legs themselves. From 45 degrees to 45 degrees. All right. Now we return to this very simple movement. And we do this first in that 45 degrees. So I'll show this from both angles. And from the side, you see it goes to the right and to the left. So you're leading with a lot more awareness in the hips. Also, you start the movement, usually it goes in one sort of a wave and you just ride it. It's always important to change the direction of the wave, because you get hit in one way, you hit in another way. Michael, please. Here. If something both pushes and pulls on us at the same time, here, see? No, on the body, this doesn't work. Yeah, it pushes and pulls at the same time. Here, see, if I just get bent, I get bent. But if I'm able to perform, see, I just take a step, but the step is three-dimensional. Again, let's say from a different angle. Doesn't matter, just push and pull on the body here, see? Get moved. Instead, you're able to, see, just continue on. So, we've done this eight figure. Now we'll do the other 45 degrees. So, see, 45 degrees, forward and backward. And you just add this movement to it. And you change the direction every so often. Most important, keep breathing. And smiling is not too terrible as well. Okay. Now, we sort of like painted a roundabout flower around the body. Now let's see if we can do this as we are as we are moving from place to place. We are meant to work on 2 feet, which means that we're actually standing on 1 foot at a time, also. So I'll show from both angles. I'm going to start doing something very simple. I'll stand on one leg, yes? And I do the simplest circle, around and around. Around and around. And then the other leg, around and around, around and around. I'll go through this, I'll zip through this very simply because we've already done it. We're just shifting it to one leg. Let's show from the side, for example, the different heights of the spine movement around the hips, but only now doing it on one leg. Why? Because that's how we're going to be moving or flying. So from here, I'll show a full circle of shoulders, chest, ribs, stomach, hips one way, and then go up in the other direction. I'll show this, for, let's say, from a 45 degree angle, if the camera is still shooting. And from here, you see, one, chest, ribs, stomach, fully on. And then let's say on the other foot, on the other angle, from here in the other direction, shoulders, chest, ribs, stomach. And as you can see, this is a good exercise for your balance as well, all the way around. So do this one direction and then another. It looks a lot easier than it actually is, especially if you're not used to doing that sort of work. Do this with breathing and with smiling, it will be a lot easier. So one leg, and remember that the other leg can move. You don't have to put it in a stiff way in any direction. And don't put it away from you as a counterbalance that is stiff. If you want it as a counterbalance, for example, if you are top heavy, just see, you do it in a way that works for you. See, this way, it works for you. Side again, one leg is in the air. the other way. This is quite fun after you get used to it. Now, after that you've done this on either leg, on both legs, hopefully, then you can start doing actually moving of the hips themselves while on one foot. For example, I'm walking, yes, and someone comes and starts to push me from the side. One, two, oh look, I'm on one foot. Do I need to gain purchase again or just keep moving? I'll show fast and then slow. I'm walking, see, just continue to walk, continue to move yourself. Now slowly, one, two, one, two. You can do all sorts of bad and good things. If it's a drunk in a party, you don't necessarily have to punch him, unless he owes you money. So, from here, you start with one leg in the air, and you simply do this movement. From side to side, side to side. Make sure that you don't overstretch yourself. Move with comfort and keep your body relaxed. If I keep this leg in the air, you see, this doesn't move. The center of the hips does not move. Allow the hip to move and yourself to move. Side to side. Again, from the other side here, this does not move. If you are working by yourself, a very simple way to see if you're actually moving your hips in a way that you don't want to is to take a stick or a band, anything that is stiff enough, put it against the wall and place it with enough tension to just keep it on the wall for yourself, and then you do it in this way. And you learn what you're moving and what you're not moving. The same thing can be held on any other point that you want except for the eyeballs. So, we did this, one leg. Now, we'll do something that is far more important and actually a lot easier in a way. I'm going to show this from the front and the side here. This does not move. What I do a up and down motion. So from here, see, up and down, see? Relaxing, relaxing again. Remember that you use the weight to your benefit. So if I'm here and this leg is down, this leg is pulling downward. So it actually moves me upward. I'll show this again from the front. If this leg is down, this is the weight that brings it up. I don't need excess tension to do this. Just breathe. Keep your legs as comfortably under you as you can. This is not a kick. It's just walking, just a side bit of weight. Also, make sure that you're not concentrating your entire mass or just a slim part of the foot. Not necessarily a good thing for your health. Do this with both. Good. And now, we're going to start doing small circles with both hips. So I am on one hip, yes, one foot, and foot is in the air, I'm doing circles with it. One way, and another way. I'll show this from the side, here, one way, another way. Other leg. The foot itself is relaxed. Good. Now that we've done this, we're going to repeat the same movement, but on the leg that is on the ground. So from here, if this leg is in the air, now this hip is going to circle. Obviously, this is one bone, so the other one also moves. But you just have to see where you place your attention. So from here, this leg that is on the ground has to move in a circle, which means that it has to relax and unwind one way and then another. I'll show this from the side. This leg is on the ground, so this leg, well, this hip creates a circle, it moves. Again from the front, one way, another way, one way, another way. In the beginning it might look a bit strange, but after a while you see the great benefit of this drill. If I'm walking and again someone pushes me, pulls me, whatever it is, see, there's not going to be a transference of tension. I'm not going to tense up against something if I don't have to. This tension, if I'm walking and something pushes me, comes from lack of awareness in the spine, lack of awareness in the hips. If I'm on one leg, moment, from the nose, we are outside, and people are slowing down to see what we're doing, which is good in a way. Again, something comes and pushes. The way that I tense up is because this leg is holding me up, or so I consider it. Instead of holding me up, it is supposed to move from the body. If my leg is pushing me forward, I just go to end up like this, you know. Yep. That's not the way that men are supposed to walk. The body moves the leg. So from here, I'll show again from the side, this. I'm not lifting the leg forward, I'm relaxing this leg forward. See? Here, relaxing this leg. It's just rolling upwards. That's a nice way to put it. Now, if I'm on one foot, as if I'm walking and something pushes me, if this leg is stiff, I am moved. Or I can compensate with the spine, and compensation comes with a price. Again, from here comes the matrix, and you get all sorts of nice martial arts moves from that, but not necessarily going to work, especially if you're with a backpack on you. However, if you're here, and you just remember that this is the foot, and that's all it is, just relax, okay? Relax. In and through. Alright, so we've done this. Now we're going to do two circles following each other with the hips. What does that mean? I'll put my hands on my hips, one leg is in the air, both of them are moving, yes? Both of them are moving. One way, another way. I'll show with the other leg, this is in the air, both of them are moving. If you come from a Latin background, this might be a little bit easier for you because of the culture, not because of your color. Like so, I'll show from the side. Both are moving, which means that I'm actually moving my hips and my body because the other hip is not on the ground. Like so. Now, it's a general thing to do, just, I do this and I feel that this moves as well. But you don't just move this part, you move both of them together. It means that the body and the spine actually have to move you in this direction. If you don't do it, then you neglect a part. Michael, this will hurt. What can I do? Okay, so someone is here. Mm-hmm. Now, if this comes in a way that Michael is not aware here, this way, it sinks in. Now, this happens because he's currently moving this hip, but not remembering this one. Now, if you are placing yourself in the other hip as well, not just as well, this just going to be movement. If it's not, if it's just stiff in the other leg, this will be a good entry point for his demise. Now, if you're being pushed and pulled and hit, see, just relax it. You don't press it, you don't try to analyze it, you don't try to deflect it. And this also goes with the arms as well. If I try to deflect here, move here, I'm just guiding him to me because there is excess tension in my movement. Now, if I'm just, the body moves and the arms move from it, then it easily comes to a conclusion, hopefully a good one, because even if you're good, it doesn't make you immortal or special. Now, after that we've done this, paying attention to both hips, let's try to do this while actually moving. So, I'm taking, let's say, 3 steps from the camera, and I'm walking 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, yes? While I'm doing this, I'll start with this. Yes? Now, I've done this. Now I'm going to do the same while I'm turning. So, Now I've done this, walking forward, backwards, and turning one side and the other. Now I'm going to do the same thing, only in a different movement. So for example, I'm just taking this, and I'm doing this while I'm walking forward and backwards. Now we do the same thing, only turning again. So as you can see, when you are incapacitating, well, putting together two movements or three together, things become a little bit complicated in the head. But if you just allow the movement to come and not try to synchronize it, then it will work for you. If you are trying to synchronize the movements, you know, one, two, one, two, it will become a dance, because you're working in nature, you're working with people, and people do not necessarily play along. So if I'm trying to look graceful, you know, one, two, three, you know, it's just not going to work. It's going to look maybe from a scene from a movie, and not necessarily a good one. However, if I'm allowing two rhythms to just exist and go through me, that's going to be different. See, from here, one, that's all, one. Why? Because it's a continuous one. If it comes from the back, I'm standing, looking at something, I'm being surprised. Instead of trying to control anything, instead of trying to manipulate or become stronger, you know, appear strong, just a limit. But if the hand is moved, not for my, well, not just for my muscles, but also for my movements, here, see? That's very easy to get to a point where you are not attacking, where you are not defending, you're just moving. This is the physical point of it. There is a lot of mental work that needs to be done with breath awareness, which we won't be covering right now, but this is just as important. I'm just showing the mostly physical part at the moment. It's not everything, necessarily, obviously not everything. So, walk and do two movements at the same time, forward, backward, side to side. And when this becomes easy, we also add another element of simply moving lower, meaning that I don't crawl on the ground at this point. I just go, let's say, 5 centimeters. Many martial arts do this. You just walk and you keep your legs under you, forward and backwards, but they're obviously more under more tension, because it's not the proper extension, and it's turning. And so on. Now, if you've done this and you're sort of comfortable, let's say for a few minutes like this, then it's a good thing to do another drill that we do with the hips, which is really good for general awareness. And this is going to be the conclusion of this part of the video. Now look if you can see both of us. Michael? What do? We squat. After about 15 to 16 minutes, it's quite really relaxing. And you see, if you're bent forward, it means that your hips are not relaxed. We start with just placing a hand or making any sort of contact. And my point of it is just to move. If from here I tense up and I try to push him, from this position I'm obviously making myself more stiff as well. So if I tense and push and he pushes me, I lose my ground or lose the working parts of myself. Very good, Michael. Next time, try to break it. So, I'm here, I'm placing a hand, contact, not a hand, press, force. The hand and the body moves. Yes? It looks a lot easier than it is, I think. Again, he puts his hand on me, and I need to just not to breathe, but to keep breathing. And as he moves, I relax another part of me. Not necessarily this part, because if I just relax this part, you know, it again becomes some sort of a matrix movement. And that's not necessarily what I want to do. Instead, from here, as he moves, relax. It gives me the opening naturally. And when you stay down again for a few minutes, it builds a good
good part of your movement there. So again, you put a place there, and again, you don't press, you just relax your movement. And then he does the same for you. Yeah? Relax. Relax. It's a wonderful drill to do. Again, someone puts their hand on you, just relax. Sit here, relax. And if, for example, it comes from behind, people tend to, you know, stiffen up again. What will I do? Instead, remember that you have two legs. Yes, you take a step, and then the same step you change your direction. That takes away from the whole being pushed from the back and being the woman from Titanic. You know, if it comes from the side, see here. If I'm tense, I just forget that this leg, although it is being more pressed, it can move. That's a lot easier this way. Okay. Bear with me. Okay. Six.